All right, everybody. I think it's time we do another warm water bass fly. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Savage Flies. I'm Matt. Thanks for stopping by. So I sat down today thinking it's about time we do another warm water fly, maybe a big bass pattern or a big brown trout pattern. I grabbed Dick Stewart and Farrell Allen's flies for bass and panfish, flipped through here till I found one that looked pretty cool. And oddly enough, it was an Al Troth pattern. We all know Al Troth. He is the originator of the elk hair caddis, one of the greatest dry flies of all time. Now, we've talked about Al Troth on this channel before. He's from out in Montana. He created this fly in the early 60s for fishing on the Madison River, and he really created this one for the big brown trout out there. But a lot of bass fishermen found out it works pretty well for them too, and it's going to be a good pattern really anywhere you have the bullhead, which is kind of catfish fry. It's a big, looks like a sculpin too. It's got a big meaty head. Gets really down low. It's pretty much a bottom feeder, but we are going to tie this one weighted. We want it to get down pretty deep. And although it does have a spun deer hair head, we're not spinning it real tight. We just don't want it too buoyant. We want it to get down pretty easily. And there are no exotic materials to this thing. Most all of us have these materials, and it's not really that hard to tie other than spinning the deer hair head and getting it trimmed kind of like a muddler minnow head. That's about the only tricky part on it. But the good news is, if you mess that up and you got an ugly fly, the thing's still gonna fish. Might not be pretty enough to post onto Instagram, but put it in your fly box. It's gonna work. So it's a pretty cool pattern. I think all you bass fishermen out there are gonna like it, or any of you that target the big browns, this thing could work for you too. So there it is in the vise, a Troth bullhead. Now I'm tying this pretty big. It's a size 6, at a 3X long. I'm gonna go ahead and pinch the barb right there. Did I get that? I think so. And this is a curved shank hook. You don't need to be on a curved shank hook, but I think it does look pretty cool. And I am going to weight this thing. And I'm using some thick stuff. This is 020. I'm going to weight probably the back 2/3. And I'm gonna put down a black thread. I'll put a little dam right behind this weight to lock it in. A few wraps over it, and then a few more up front. And take it on the back. And you don't really need to build a ramp right there. We can use the material to fill that in. Now the first part of the tail is white bucktail. And the bucktail I'm working off of is getting pretty sparse. I don't have a whole lot of good hair left, but a pretty long piece. I'm gonna go about right there, and I'm gonna tie it a good bit around the bend of the hook because I kind of want it pointing down. So that, I think that's gonna work right there, and I will leave this hair right here just to kind of fill in that gap between the hook and the weight. Now the next part of the tail, big fluffy black marabou. So a big tuft of marabou right here, about the same length as the white. Just gonna catch it in right on top right here. You can lick your fingers if it gets a little bit unwieldy on you, and then just band it together. So I think that's gonna be fine. You can't really see that white because it's pointing down, but you'll be able to see it when this thing's fluttering through the water. So just a couple of wraps right there. Don't trim this off yet. That's going to be our shellback kind of piece. And the topping for the tail, just peacock herl. And I'm going to get a little crazy. I'm going to use about 6 strands right here. I suppose you could substitute some kind of flash for it. But I think if you did that, I would probably only do about 2 strands because 4 or 5 strands of crystal flash would probably overwhelm it. Okay, so get that caught in. 3 or 4 good wraps right there. We've got our white underneath and the black marabou and the peacock herl. Now let's take our thread right in front of this and catch in some white yarn for the body. And this is just a white synthetic. It was a
three strand, I believe, and I've split it up. So I'm just going to wrap one of the strands. Catch it in right back there where we're going to start wrapping it. And we'll bring our thread right in front of the weight. We do have a bit of a head up here, a deer hair collar and head. So that's the body. We don't want the body too much more than, I would say, 2/3 of the hook shank. So go ahead and wrap this up. And you can do come up and back and down again if you want a big thick body. I'm not sure how necessary that is, but we'll see. Yeah, let's make it a little thicker. I'm going to take another wrap. Might let this yarn flatten out a little bit on me and go down and then back up again. Okay, let's catch off this white underbody. And I think we've got a nice cigar-shaped body right there. That's going to work for us. So two or three wraps to catch this off. Now let's snip this excess. And we'll fold over the marabou. And I'm going to do it one at a time because I want to kind of spin this marabou to tighten it up just a little bit. I don't want it to be overly fluffy on the top there. So let's do two wraps and see what that does for us. Okay, that's an all right looking top piece, I guess. I'm gonna take a few extra wraps just to lock that in. Now I'm gonna wrap this peacock herl over. Just gives it a little bit of metallic gold and green sheen on top right here. This kind of sets that black off a little bit nicer right there. Okay, a couple extra wraps. Now we'll trim this. Now the last thing we're going to do, tie in some deer hair. This is a natural and it is a spinning hair. If you don't have hair that's made specifically for spinning, it'll be fine. But it just might be a little bit harder to spin it. And I'm going to do it about halfway back. So I'm going to catch this first clump in with the tips about halfway back. I'm going to do two loose wraps and then spin it around, let it go all the way around with that third wrap. Now I'll just work my thread up through, get to the front of it. Now I'm going to try this little piece right here. This is just a water bottle lid. I drilled a little hole in it and I'm going to see if this packs it any easier than what I normally do with my fingers. And maybe it did. We'll see. Take a thread a couple turns up and then tie in another piece, maybe just a little bit thicker than the one we just did. Going to lay it on my side of the hook here, and then another two loose wraps, and then let it spin around on the third. Now, here's where you have to ask yourself, do you want to try to put one more on? I probably have room to do a small clump, but you want to be careful and don't get your head too big. You want this fly to sink, and too much of a deer hair head, and it just might, you know, be a little too buoyant. Let's try another small clump. Okay, we'll see if this is going to cause me too much trouble or if I would have been better off stopping where I was. But I'm always living on the edge, so two loose wraps right here and then spin it around. Okay, we got that one on there, but is it going to be a messy head? It might. We'll see. So I've got my thread the very front. Pack that in a little bit. A few extra wraps right here. Just get us some room for a whip finish. So now's where you want to be careful. Take your time and trim this off. I'm going to use a combination of my razor blade tool here and then scissors, but just go slow. If you cut too much, you can't put it back. Now I'm going to speed this up so you don't have to watch it in real time. All right, now spend as much time as you want trimming it. This is probably fine and fishable right there, but I'm gonna get a little picky and just try to cut a little bit more right here. And I think that's fine. That head could be a little bit smoother, but I'm gonna live with it. Put this thing in my box. Maybe a drop of head cement under there. So there you go, folks. The Troth Bullhead. Not terribly hard to tie, but a pretty nifty looking pattern. So I appreciate you watching. Y'all take care, and we'll see you next time.